Okay, so again, like I said yesterday, it was all about the multiplication and division. Now, let me tell you what's the biggest struggle for students doing this unit. It's crazier than you think. This whole idea, this whole topic, it's not really that challenging. But what's going to happen for hopefully some students or a minority of students or maybe nobody, hopefully, is that they're not really reading. Let me repeat one more time. There are students who try so hard to do this unit by not reading. And you're like, wait, hold on. What do you mean by not reading? What I mean by not reading is that they just look at the fractions and they don't pay attention to the sign in between those two fractions. So this multiplication or this division, they mean nothing to them. And therefore, oh, they screw up because, I mean, there's a reason why we put a sign right there. And you do this, you do whatever needs to be done based on the sign. Like, for example, if you go to the worksheet, question number 7, we're looking at this. We're like, oh, yeah, you have a fraction divided by x minus 7. What does that mean? And we say, oh, that means we have this fraction times 1 over x minus 7. First, you got to read. And second, you have to believe that this is really nothing new. This is exactly the same thing that you learned back in middle school. However, some people, they like to make this, or they are not aware that this is really the old stuff. So, well, instead of thinking that it's the old stuff, they thought that it is a completely new stuff. They're like, oh, it's so overwhelming, so overwhelmingly difficult. And they gave up. And I was like, it's the same thing. Yes, it's new. You got a factor, like right here. But you should know how to factor, I guess. Right? So then you have this. And you can go ahead and write down the restrictions, right? So here's another thing. Restrictions, just the and yesterday I was talking to a few students and they happened to have the same problem. They would say something like this. They would say, oh, I forgot to do this. Oh, I forgot this. I forgot about that. And I want you to know that if this is what you say, that could be a bigger problem. And it is not about your memory. Your memory is fine. The problem is, why did you forget? And chances are, again, it's not about your memory. It's about how you structure your memory. The reason why you might forget things is, well, you kind of stuff it into your brain without reasoning, without meanings. And our brain is pretty good in just letting go of stuff when there's no meaning. Like, would you ever forget that I missed a chance? I don't think you will. But then you start asking, why not? Okay. So there's always a reason. Okay. There's always a reason. Oops, sorry, hold on. There's always a reason for you to do something. If you don't understand the reason, I'm sorry. If you don't understand the reason, that means you're forcing your way to memorize something, and that's gonna be hard on your brain. Like, for example, why is the restriction 7 right here? X could be 0. What cannot be 0? The denominator cannot be 0. Why not?
Because it'll be undefined.
Because it'll be undefined. There's a reason. But do you know the reason? If you don't know the reason, then your brain will just end up memorizing and you will forget. That's my lesson learned when I was in high school. Okay. And it cannot be negative 2. Because if it's negative 2, this parenthesis would become 0 and the whole denominator would become 0. And that's no good. And that's all. That's the restrictions, right? And now we can start canceling things out. And that's the only thing we can cancel out. So at the end, we will have a fraction. And that is x minus 2 in the numerator and x plus 2 times x minus 7 in the denominator. And we're just going to leave it like this. And again, if you think it's difficult, sometimes you got to ask yourself, did you make it more difficult? Because it's not supposed to be difficult. It's high school. Come on, high school. It's not college. It's not doctoral degree. How hard would it be? That's the mentality I actually had when I was teaching geometry, because I used to not like geometry out of all the math courses. I would say geometry is my last choice. And then I kind of put in a position in summer school that if I don't teach geometry, then I would have no job over the summer. And I kind of need the money that summer. And then I was like, all right, I guess I would do it. And then that's what I told myself. How hard would it be? It's for freshman and sophomore. How hard would it be? It wasn't. It was just me the whole time. Okay. So now we are going to transition to today's stuff.